It's Retro Pixels here once again, and we are doing a new series today. We are playing Transport Giant Steam Edition, made back in 2004 by Joe Wood, the Austrian games developer. Now I'm just going to quickly turn down the music because that is really loud. There we go. I did do this video yesterday and forgot to turn the microphone on. So I did a 45 minute video and literally forgot to put the mic on. So yeah, so we're back redoing it. So what we're going to do is work our way through the campaign. We're going to do a video for each campaign level. I'm just going to quickly, no, it's not that one. Players, so Retro Pixels Transport, got me logo. I'm leaving the vehicles in their default colour schemes, so you get to see all the different vehicles out there. So we're going to go to campaign. So we've got three to choose from. We've got the USA, which supposedly is easy. The Australian, which was a DLC originally. You had to buy an extra disc for the Australian DLC, but it comes complete with this version. And then you've got the European hard version. So we're just going to do USA. Click confirm. So as you can see, there's two missions now, because I did do the Wild West yesterday. Then messed up, so I'm going to redo it. So select that one. Confirm. So here we are. Basically, the idea with the campaign, or with this mission in the campaign, is to build up the five forts dotted across the map. I'll leave that up for a second if you want to read it, but it's basically just telling you what you've got to do. So deliver construction materials to the various forts, and you've got 10 years to do it. So there's a fort there. Confirm. Easy. So all our manufacturing is going to be here. So what we're going to do is bills. Start first route. Get one of those ones. Spin that round. Go. I'm just connect that up. And while that's building, we'll plan the next route, which is going to be out there. Give it a reasonably long access road so vehicles can queue. There we go. Let's create a road schedule, so it is that one. From Wooding Centre, picking up tree trunks. We'll go to Wooding North to drop them off. And just duplicate. There we go. And while that's doing that, we'll do. Do this one first. So spin that round. Build it opposite. There we go. Thank you. I've messed it all up. Schedule. Let's try that again. It's been a while since I played this, so I'm still trying to remember all the controls. Yeah, that's better. So that should now be enough to do all the various forts that are dotted across the map. So we'll just go along here just to show you. So that's the first one. So it requires 50, already delivered 0, but that'll just soon change to delivered 1, and so on. Here, we're just going to have a quick look and just see if there's any other routes we can do to pick up some more money in the process. Okay, so we could do that as well. So, so the farm produces wool. That's more of a cotton farm, but I'll go with what the name says. There we go. See, as the items get delivered to the, I want to call them landmarks, because that's what, in the endless game, that's what they are, but you'll see it will actually start to build and look more and more realistic as the deliveries are made. Okay, and what's the lowest will do? Wool. Ooh. Go with that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So create a new schedule. So there's various cargoes across the map. So for instance, we've obviously got tree trunks and wooden boards. You've got wool from the cotton plantation, which delivers to a textile industry that makes clothing. We can produce whiskey if you can find some corn. Cigars if you can find tobacco. That's corn there, so we might even do that as well. So it's got a bit of money coming in. What else have we got? We have whiskey again. Corn. Tobacco. Wool. Tree trunks. Whiskey. Cigars. iron ore. And some more iron ore. Tree trunks. So yeah, you get the idea. Okay, while that's doing that, what we will do is roads. Let's try and get up there, because there's one up there. Up there. Across to there. Quite almost. There we go. There's another one up here as well. It's more connected now. We'll take. So it needs another 16 and it's done. Just popping along with the music here. last one. Yep, okay. And there we are, all nice and pristine. Go. We'll start again. Also, when the landmark is finished, it will allow you to pick up passengers and dispatch them to towns like. So, passengers to Port Frontier Town Centre is now an option. Which is there. There we are. To that route as well, just to increase the earnings. In the bank, we'll do another, set up another route. Is it started building yet? No. Can't be far off though. regular little traffic jam there. Hey, another one done. So that's Frontier Town Centre. So that's it. I've literally just got to wait now. Just can't move for a traffic jam, a horse traffic jam. feels that noise gets a bit repetitive after a while. You end up with towns becoming congested. So we'll just put a few roads in to try and alleviate that. Sorted. Bypass. So we're looking almost done. It's virtually done as well. should be the last one. There we go. So that's Desert City Center. Since we don't need them anymore, we'll sell the horses, make a bit more money. Forward and sell them, which is okay, so that's Wooding West. Done it with 4 years to spare. Well, hey! Woohoo! You've fulfilled all requirements and solved this mission.
Yeah, boy.
Right, well, I hope you enjoyed that quick taster, guys. If you did, don't forget to hit the thumbs up, leave us a comment, tell us what you think, because if people like it, then we'll carry on and do the full campaign. If you don't, well, it's just one episode, so it's not a massive issue. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. It is in the bottom right-hand corner. Obviously, we can't keep making videos without the subscribers, so keep sharing, tell all your mates, or laugh at me being a complete idiot on the other side of the microphone. And I'll see you all very soon. Enjoy the rest of your day, guys, and I'll catch you all later. Bye-bye. Thank you.